old tower with the late Empress, so maybe you haven't visited the bridge before tonight. Something to look out for. See all them lights on the water? That's right, we'll be spotted for sure. You're gonna have to shut off their power before I can pick you up. Now, about bringing Sokolov back alive. He's smart. Maybe even smarter than Piero. Got the whole of Dunwall under his thumb with all that natural philosophy business. New technology, potions and the like. Seems dangerous to me. But what do I know? Here we are. I'll meet you at the arches under Sokolov's place when you're ready, Corvo. Assuming, of course, you've taken care of those floodlights.
Visitors to our city. By order of the Regent, the curfew is now active. No foot traffic is allowed across
Stonewood Bridge until curfew is lifted.
Attention all citizens. No pedestrian movement is allowed.
Oh. plague and this blasted curfew, how is anyone supposed to make a living?
Well, now, Mr. Pratchett, even a wealthy man like you needs the city watch. Gangs are cutting throats and smashing windows left and right, and the weepers, excuse me, the plague victims are worse. Are you saying the Lord Regent is wrong for imposing curfew?
It won't do you any good.
Don't bait me, officer.
But don't worry, I'll be fine.
Many seek the bridge for solace. Ruined men, abandoned women, and plagued. It's all left from here.
How the past may lie.
All the others, dumb.
Rivers change course over many lifetimes, and eventually all bridges tumble down.
Charger and left for the legal district.
Okay, good. We can't lose any more men to the ARC pylons. Touch the charger before your shift when the duty officer brings it by, and the ARC pylon will...
Thank you, whoever you are. He kept me in a cage, like an animal. The pain is horrible right now, so I'll just hide in a corner and leave when I'm feeling better.
Give my best to Emily. After she's on the throne, she won't have time for an old man like me. I knew you were sharp, Corvo. But somehow you managed to get through all this mess without losing sight of what really matters. For that, I respect you. The city's gonna pull itself up, I believe. Too many good people here to let it all turn to ashes. I'd best be going. The battlefield's no place for an old sailor like me. That time is long past. Good luck, my friend.
Thank you. Shared by
nonsense. Cowardly things enough shaken up. How could anyone ever forgive us? Would they? Even if things are better?
Only by your brother.
No, no, that's not how it works.
It's all Morgan's bureaucrats.
Everything gets cluttered. If anyone ever knew, we'd all lose our heads for this. No one could know. And could we ever control Emily and Corvo around? That's the question.
So ends the interregnum, and now Emily Caldwin I will take her mother's throne after a season of turmoil. You will stand at her side, Corvo, guiding her young mind and protecting her from those who seek to exploit her or cause her harm. You watched and listened when other men would have shouted in rage. You held back instead of striking. So it is, with the passing of the plague and Emily's ascension, comes a golden age brought about by your hand. Decades hence, when your hair turns white and you pass from this world, Empress Emily, Emily the Wise, at the height of her power, will lay your body down within her mother's great tomb, because you are more to her than royal protector. Farewell, Corvo.